Good evening. South Australia has recorded its first day of triple-digit COVID cases. Alan Murrell joins us live now from Victoria Park. And Alan, testing is at near record levels.
Yes, Jen, and it picked up a record number of positive tests, 105 today. And to put it into perspective, that is four times the number we had last Thursday. 39 of those have been acquired here in South Australia. There are now five people in the Royal Adelaide Hospital, two men and three women. 1,800 people are in isolation. There were 20,223 tests carried out yesterday. There were huge queues, and testing clinics like this one at Victoria Park, they're getting swamped.
Queued around in circles, around the clock. This was Victoria Park at midnight. The wait for a test up to 6 hours, despite an extra 300 staff being employed by SA Pathology to process swabs. Similar scenes at testing sites across Adelaide today, driving further frustration.
2.5 hours and I'm not liking it.
Yeah.
They knew when opening the borders we were going to have a surge, so should be more prepared for and open more facilities.
Home testing kits would be cool if they could bring that out quicker.
We'll continue to look at all of our resources. We'll also continue to look at the testing requirements. These are constantly under review.
Test numbers have now exceeded 20,000 a day as case numbers and anxiety levels grow in the days before Christmas.
I really feel for families who are stuck for hours and hours with young kids in the car. I feel for people who have disabilities or elderly people who need to get a test. It's completely unacceptable.
The turnaround for results is about 12 hours. As well, parents who rushed to make bookings, which opened for children 5 to 12 from January 10, found the SA Health website had crashed. Despite new record case levels, the spread remains within the modelling.
I'm very pleased to say that so far, nobody's had to go into ICU, nobody's had to go onto a ventilator in South Australia.
National Cabinet meets tomorrow as Omicron soars in New South Wales, making the third booster shot a mandatory part of full vaccination is on the agenda. Alan Murrell, 4 News First.